Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Let's begin with the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent, the Most Merciful. The topic of my research article is the evaluation of biological properties of pure biofeminine chemicals and aroma substances from cannabis sativa essential oil. I'm Dr. Simon Az. Currently, I'm working as assistant professor at University of Education Lahore, Multan campus. First of all, please accept my sincere thanks and gratitude for the excellent support provided by the technical staff, administrative staff, and organizing and committee. And a bundle of thanks for inviting me to share my research work at this great platform of the first international conference on research in biological sciences. I start with the introduction. What are the bioactive compounds? These are the compounds typically found in small amounts in plants and certain foods, fruits, vegetables, nuts, etc. Bioactive compounds have actions in the body that may promote good health. They are being studied in the prevention of cancer, heart diseases, and other diseases. Many examples of bioactive compounds are lycopene, lignin, tannins, and indoles. Bioactive compounds are secondary metabolites found in small quantities in various plants. They are the most hydrophobic and poorly soluble compounds. The major class of bioactive compounds are terpenes and terpenoids, alkaloids, and phenolic compounds. You can see various examples of bioactive compounds at screen, including limonene, carvone, lycopene, beta carotene. These are terpenes and terpenoids, including alkaloids, caffeine, piperine, and quinine. And phenolic compounds include gallic acid, cholestine, and cyanidine. You can see the structure of various bioactive compounds here. And what are the biofine chemicals and aroma substances? An aromatic compound, also known as odorant, aroma, fragrance, or flavor, is a chemical compound that has a smell or odor. Aromatic compounds can be found in foods, wines, spices, perfumes, fragrances, oils, and essential oils. When these chemicals are obtained in purified form, these are known as pure biofine chemicals. And the essential oil is a concentrated hydrophobic liquid containing volatile aromatic compounds from plants. Essential oils are also known as volatile oils or ethereal oils. Now, what was my plant of research? That was cannabis sativa. Cannabis sativa or hemp is an annual herbaceous plant and it belongs to Cannabaceae family. Two other subspecies are Cannabis sativa and Cannabis indica, also known as bhang or hemp in Pakistan. Its seeds, flowers, its stems and roots, etc. are used for various purposes of medicine industry and fiber industry, etc. And the flowers and the lesser extent the leaves, stems and seeds contain psychoactive chemical compounds known as cannabinoids that are consumed for recreational, medicinal and spiritual purposes. Cannabis sativa essential oil, also known as hemp oil, is obtained by distillation from flowers and upper leaves of C. sativa plant. And its essential oil is pale yellow or golden yellow liquid. Cannabis flowers and leaves essential oil is a volatile oil that is a mixture of volatile compounds including monoterpenes, sesquiterpenes and other terpenoid-like compounds. This essential oil is also used as a scent in perfumes, cosmetics, soaps, candles, beverages and also used as flavoring in food, primarily in candies and beverages. What was the purposes of this research work or aims and objectives? Were the extraction of bioactive compounds from this plant, isolation and characterization, analysis of extracted essential oils and the fractionation, and after that analysis of that fractions, and finally biological applications of separated bioactive compounds. Plant collection was done from Sunskeser Valley in the northwest of Kushab district, Punjab. And this climate of this area was very suitable for the growth of this plant. Hemp was collected in the month of September at 27 Celsius. These are the various claims of C. sativa collection. Qualitative analysis including analysis or isolation of alkaloid glycosides, flavonoids, tannic acids, phenols, steroids and triterpenoids, saponins and anthraquinones was performed, and the quantitative analysis of other phytoconstituents like alkaloids, identification of glycosides, flavonoids, tannic acids, steroids, triterpenoids, saponins and anthraquinones were performed. Both qualitative and quantitative analysis of these groups was performed. Physicochemical analysis involve analysis of physical properties like color, odor, boiling point, density, specific gravity, pH, solubility, consistency, optical rotation, refractive index, and chemical analysis included acid value, ester value, and flash point. Proximate analysis was done by analyzing percentage moisture, ash, proteins, fiber, lipid contents, as well as carbohydrate contents. Phytochemical extraction of cannabis sativa was performed by using Soxhlet apparatus in the analytical chemistry lab at University of Agriculture, Faisalabad. It was done by grinding sample, finally filling the thimble of Soxhlet extractor, and filtration and solvent evaporation. After that, extract was collection. After filling the thimble, reflux was set up, and after that, extract was collected and filtered. Filtration and solvent evaporation of these extract was performed. Extraction of essential oil was completed in batch process of hydro distillation, steam distillation, and supercritical fluid extraction at Rosa Lab, Institute of Horticultural Sciences, University of Agriculture, Faisalabad. Hydro distillation and steam distillation was done at three temperatures, 110, 120, and 130 Celsius, but a supercritical fluid extraction was performed at 40 Celsius and 45 Celsius by keeping pressure at 80 and 82 bar. This is the flow chart of extraction of essential oil. This is the instrument of supercritical fluid extraction. This is a hydro distiller. This is steam distiller. After extraction from the hemp plant, essential oil was collected. Its residue was discarded. Collected essential oil was stored in dark colored bottles at moderate temperature. Later on, fractionation of cannabis sativa phytochemicals or extract and fractionation of essential oil was performed parallel. In fractionation of extract, we use various solvents with polarity changes from most polar to semi-polar and non-polar solvent. You can see methanol extract, hexane extraction, carbon disulfide, benzene fraction, ether fraction, ethyl acetate, and chloroform fraction. And these are various fractions obtained on the basis of polarity of solvent. This is the fractionation of extract. Chloroform fraction, acetone fraction, 2-butanol fraction, acetic acid, and ethanol fraction. Finally, at the end, we collected 50% methanol fraction. This is the fractionation of various cannabis sativa phytochemicals. This is the various steps of extraction. And this is partition fractionation by using this thimble. Partition fractionation of solvent is the usual traditional technique of the fractionation of various bioactive compounds. Fractions were collected and stored in dark colored bottles at room temperature. Fractionation of essential oil was performed by using vacuum fractional distillation. Is the separation of essential oil into its component fractions, such as in separating chemical compounds by their boiling point by heating them to a temperature at which one or more fraction of the compound will vaporize and the pressure of the essential oil to be distilled is reduced to less than its vapor pressure, causing evaporation of the most volatile compounds. This is the glimpse of fractionation. We take 50 ml oil in flask, attach thermometer with it, and you can see fractional distillation apparatus. This is a vigorous column. This is a vacuum pump, and Liebig condenser was attached along with it, and the various fractions were collected at constant pressure by varying temperatures at various times. यू कैन सी द कलेक्टेड फ्रैक्शंस. तीसरा अनुसार एनालिसिस ऑफ बायोएक्टिव कंपाउंड वाज परफॉर्म्ड. The CCMS analysis was done at the instrument present not in Pakistan but in Sultan Qaboos University in Muscat, Oman. After analysis, determination of antioxidant compounds by SPLC was another technique used along with GCMS for the identification of phytochemicals or phenolic compounds, or you can see antioxidant compounds. These are various conditions of mobile phase or detector of this instrument. SPLC was performed at University of Agriculture, Faisalabad. Finally, after quantitative and qualitative complete analysis, biological and pharmacological potential of cannabis sativa essential oil was performed by practicing insecticide activity, antimicrobial, antidiabetic, anti-inflammatory, gastroprotective, hepatoprotective, and anti-cancer properties. Determination of total phytochemical contents was performed by determining total phenolic contents, total flavonoid contents, proanthocyanidin, flavanol, ascorbic acid, carotenoid, and antioxidant contents, and in vitro and in vivo antioxidant activities were performed. Scavenging activity of ions and radicals was performed by scavenging DPPS radical, hydroxyline, hydrogen peroxide radical, nitric oxide, ABTS radical, superoxide anion, and DMPD plus scavenging activity. Various reducing abilities of ions was performed, including ferric reducing bar assay, cupric ions reducing assay, chelating activity of ferrous ions, and inhibition of linoleic acid per oxidation. In vivo antioxidant assays were performed by using animal models of Albina western rats and rabbit skipping in Animal House Pharmacology and Microbiology Department, UAF. Ferric reducing ability of plasma, reducing glutathione estimation, glutathione peroxidase estimation, and superoxide dismutase estimation catalase activity was performed. Antimicrobial activity or antimicrobial potential was determined by using disk diffusion method and minimum inhibitory concentration method by using various gram positive and gram negative bacteria. Various strains were used. Similarly, antifungal potential was determined by disk diffusion and determination of minimum inhibitory concentration by using various strains of fungus. Aspergillus niger, Flavus, Fumigatus, Alternata, Nutatum, Anti-Herzinium, and Candida albicans. Antidiabetic activity of cannabis sativa essential oil was determined on albino rabbits kept in Animal House Pharmacological Department UFFSD by following standard methods and protocols. You can see the flowchart of determination of antidiabetic activity. First of all, numbering and grouping of rabbits was performed. After that, oral administration of various doses of essential oil was done, and after that, by taking blood samples at various time intervals, we checked the glycemic index or blood glucose level of various groups of rabbits. Cytotoxicity of cannabis sativa essential oil was performed on various animals, various insects, calabrosis analysis was performed by we used calabrosis analysis insect, and we used contact method. C analysis is the insect commonly found at homes or in various grains or pulses, etc. And this assay was also performed at Analytical Chemistry Lab, University of Agriculture, Faisalabad. Insects were collected, then we provide them microatmosphere full of vapors of essential oil. After that, we observed the mortality rate and the LC50 and LC50, LD50 and LD90 calculations. One more assay, also known as branch shrimp lethality assay, was performed to find the lethality of samples towards brine shrimp larvae, also known as the villi. The shrimp sniffer lice have been used for a number of experiments in which various samples are tested at concentration of 1000 microgram per ml, 100 microgram per ml, and 10 microgram per ml in vials containing 5 ml of brine and then a villi in each of the three replicates. Insecticidal activity was performed by following standard protocol by using various insects like Indian male moth, Rivolium gestinium, Trochoderma grenarium, and Isoptera. It was the same contact method as I discussed in previous slides. Now I come towards results and discussion. When I extracted essential oil, I found maximum yield at 110 Celsius temperature. By increasing temperature, yield of essential oil was decreased, both with the hydrodistillation and steam distillation method. And at supercritical fluid extraction method, I collected maximum yield at 40 Celsius temperature and 80 Celsius and 80 bar pressure. Various physicochemical parameters were detected, like physical and chemical parameters, colors, odor, boiling point, density, etc., as shown in this table. Qualitative analysis of phytoconstituents, analysis of alkaloids, their presence or absence was also performed. You can see the quality, color, and test of these phytochemicals, alkaloids, phenols, carbohydrates, flavonoids, steroids, etc., in this table. Hence, positive sign indicates the presence of phytochemicals. And the qualitative analysis of phytoconstituents were also performed, like testing for resins, carbohydrates, alkaloids, glycosides, and coumarins. Proximate analysis of C. sativa essential oil was performed. Moisture, ash, crude, protein, lipids, and nitrogen fixation extract. This percentage was found in leaf and stem. You can see the maximum percentage of proteins were found in leaves as well as in stem, whereas crude fiber is mostly present in stem, nowadays used in industries. And nitrogen free extract was found highest in stem at 39.7%. Various fractions were collected at various temperature ranges of the hydrodistilled, steam distilled, and supercritical fluid extracted essential oil. You can see extraction temperature and 5 fractions at various temperature ranges. The fractions are collected at various time intervals with different yield at a constant pressure of 760 mm Hg pressure. We do not vary the pressure in hydrodistillation and steam distillation, but we vary the pressure in supercritical fluid extraction. Whereas temperature was varied, you can see the various fractions of cannabis sativa extract by using solvents at various polarities. The highest yield was obtained with methanol, after that with ethanol, acetic acid, butanol, acetone, and benzene, etc. Partition fractionation of cannabis sativa extract was performed. After that, GCMS analysis of essential oil obtained at various temperatures was performed, and GCMS analysis of various fraction was also performed. You can see various peaks. And in this table, you can see the maximum contents of karyophyllene were obtained at retention time and area, and this percentage of 38.6. The major and minor components are shown in this table. We obtained in GCMS analysis of essential oil, there are various unidentified compounds. We also detected as novel compounds, and karyophyllene and humulene. Karyophyllene was the first one major compound, that is 38.6, humulene at 10.6% was obtained. After that, limonene was obtained with 7.07%, and the minor compounds like paracimol, alphabenine, and cis beta valencine, etc., were also obtained. Is the major and minor compounds obtained by steam distillation at 110 Celsius. Again, karyophyllene at 34.6% was the major compound. Similarly, this TCMS analysis of oil obtained by supercritical fluid extraction, you can see the major compound of karyophyllene at 6.65% and one unidentified compound at 14.45%. This here in this graph you can see the karyophyllene with 40.58%. These are the major compound and minor compounds at various percentages of cannabis sativa essential oil obtained by steam distillation and hydro distillation were performed. These are the structure of major constituents of cannabis sativa essential oil. Structure of myrcene, beta-pinene, limonene, alpha-pinene, trans-karyophyllene, alpha-hemolene, beta-phalanxene, etc. You can see. SP analysis of antioxidant compound was performed. Like we detected gallic acid, guarostin, metachromic acid, pyrochromic acid, 4-hydroxy-3 methoxybenzoic acid and syringic acid. Furoic acid, trans 4-hydroxy-3 methoxycinnamic acid, caffeic acid, ferulic acid, vanillic acid and synapic acid. You can see the SPLC chromatogram of cannabis sativa essential oil, hydro distilled at 112 Celsius, steam distilled at 120 Celsius and supercritical fluid extracted at 40 centigrade 80 bar. This is the graph of total phenolic contents at various temperature and by using various techniques of hydro distillation, steam distillation and supercritical fluid extraction. This is the reaction line with the standard gallic acid. This is the graph of total flavonoid contents. This is the regression line of the standard catechin that is equivalent to flavonoid contents. This is the total proanthocyanidine contents. And this is the regression line of cholestine standard. Most active fraction of cannabis sativa essential oil containing maximum phytochemical constituents, you can see with the various percentages of contents. Then total antioxidant contents was determined by ferric thiocyanate method, by phosphomolybdenum assay, and the maximum antioxidant activity is combinedly shown in this picture. This is scavenging activity of ions and radicals by DBPH radical scavenging assay, by hydroxyl ion scavenging assay, by scavenging of hydrogen peroxide radicals, nitric oxide ion scavenging assay, ABTS radical scavenging assay, and superoxide anion scavenging assay, DMPD and phenylamine dihydrochloride scavenging activity. This is the maximum radical scavenging activity of C. sativa essential oil. Then we check the reducing power abilities of the essential oil as well as fractions by checking the ferric ion reducing power at various concentration, 0.1 mg per ml, 0.2 mg per ml and 0.3 mg per ml of both essential oil as well as its fractions. This is a cupric ion reducing assay. Is the chelating activity on ferrous ions, inhibition of linoleic acid peroxidation assay, and this is the fraction of cannabis sativa essential oil having maximum chelating ability of ions. Later on, antimicrobial activity was performed by disk diffusion method against Aspergillus niger. You can see the various inhibition zones measured in millimeter against Aspergillus flavor. Against Aspergillus fumigatus, you can see various inhibition zone. Against Alternaria alternata, against P. notatum, against T. arginium, and Candida albicans. This is the combined antifungal activity of cannabis sativa solvent fractions of methanol, hexane, carbon disulfide, benzene, ether, ethyl acetate, chloroform, acetone, tubutanol, acetic acid, and ethanol fractions. Is the selected fraction showing maximum antifungal activity against all the strains were F1 fraction of 120 Celsius by steam distillation, F3 fraction of supercritical fluid extraction, F5 fraction of hydrodistilled essential oil of 112 Celsius, and F1 fraction of 130 C hydrodistilled essential oil. Is the minimum fungal fungicidal concentration of cannabis sativa essential oil against naib and niger, against A flavors, against A fumigators, against A alternata, against pinotectum, tierzanium, CLB canes, as tolerant me fair. The minimum fungicidal concentration of C sativa essential oil you can see in this graph. After fungicidal concentration determination, we performed antibacterial activity by disk diffusion method, same as the antifungal activity. Various antibacterial fractions of both steam distilled, hydro distilled, as well as supercritical fluid extracted essential oil was used. This is the antibacterial activity against S. aureus, beta subtilis, against E. aeri, against C. bifermentans, and this is the overall picture of maximum antibacterial activity of cannabis sativa essential oil. This is the minimum bactericidal concentration against E. coli, B. maltosida, S. aureus, B. subtilis, and E. aeri, and C. bifermentans. Later on, we performed determination of antidiabetic activity at various time intervals by 0 or 2 or 4, 8, 16 and 24 hours. We used various groupings of rabbits and we used the standard control and a medicine that is commonly used in the market, glimepiride and Alloxan for controlling glycemic level. And we used various fractions that were isolated as the best fractions in previous assays. We used that fraction for the determination of antidiabetic activity. This is the blood glucose level with the initial dose of 0.5 mmol per kilogram at various time intervals. This is the blood glucose level with the initial dose of 0.7 mmol per kilogram at various time intervals. Is the blood glucose level with the initial dose of 0.9 mmol per kilogram at various time intervals. This is the blood glucose level with the initial dose of 1.2 mmol per kilogram at various time intervals. This is the maximum antidiabetic activity of cannabis sativa essential oil. This is the overall picture. This is the standard glimepiride and Alloxan results. These are the results of our essential oil and various fractions obtained at various time intervals. Cytotoxicity of cannabis sativa essential oil results you can see in the slide. This is the percentage mortality of Bruch's analysis at essential oil and fractions by using 5 microliter per ml at various time intervals of 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour, 4 hour. As time lapse increases, mortality rate also increased. LT50 and LT90 values were calculated later on. This is percentage mortality of Bruch's analysis at oil and fractional concentration of 10 microliter per ml at 15 microliter per ml. This is the cytotoxicity of cannabis sativa essential oil against brine shrimps. We calculated percentage deaths, LC50 and LC90 values of brine shrimps by using various oils and isolated most active fractions. Is the percentage death at 24 or 10 ppm by at 100 ppm concentration, 1000 ppm is the LC50 and LC90 values. Then insecticidal activity was performed by using various insects like Indian meal moth, and by using 1 microliter per ml, 2 microliter per ml, 3 microliter, 4 microliter, per ml of isolated most active fractions and essential oils. The percentage mortality of this Indian meal moth. This is the insecticidal activity against Ribolium castaneum, against Cupra beetle. This is the overall insecticidal activity of most active cannabis sativa essential oil fractions. Finally, I conclude that the present study was carried out to explore the antioxidant, antimicrobial, antidiabetic, and cytotoxic potential of C. sativa essential oil extracted by different distillation methods. Maximum antioxidant and antimicrobial potentials were observed for F1, F5, and F4 of 110 Celsius, 120 Celsius, and 130 Celsius extracted cannabis sativa essential oil, which might be correlated to their more percentage of sesquiterpenoids and monoterpenoid contents as compared to pure essential oil. On the basis of our antioxidant and antimicrobial potential of C. sativa essential oil, it was selected to assess cytotoxic, acidic, and antidiabetic activity. These are the references. Thank you so much. Questions, suggestions, and comments.